Good morning, all of you. So as we know that presently we are studying, what is the importance of pH in our everyday life? Is it S? So in the last class already we have been studying the first importance of pH value in our life. That is what it is majorly important to the humans. Like particularly, what is that pH in our?
Digestion.
pH in our digestive system. Is it S or no? Yes. So here we have two antacids to control the acidity. Suppose if you are facing any kind of acidity problem, maybe few times the excess acid, hydrochloric acid, is secreted by the internal digestive system, then it may cause us paining or burning action. So for that time, we have been already discussed so many things. The dilute hydrochloric acid helps in digesting our food, but it will make it without harming the stomach. But sometimes excess of acid is produced, or else somebody is there who is protecting our stomach, the inner lining of stomach. Who is that? Who is protecting? Mucus. Have you remember? Digestive system. Biology. So if this mucus is not secreted well by our digestive system, then this hydrochloric acid will react on the inner walls of the digestive system, and it will be going to burn the inner walls. Yeah, that is what we should call it as acidity, and even it will lead to the severe problem. It is called as ulcer. So to make it neutralize, as we know, antacids being basic in nature, they will react with this excess acid in the stomach, and just they will make it neutralize. Because as we know, according to the chemistry, if acid is react with the base, what is going to happen? Please, what is going to happen? It is to make it respect to salt plus water. So this water is what we should call as neutralization reaction. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is what will happen when, if you are using the antacid or antacid, anything. So if it comes here, antacid, what do you mean by antacid? Anybody? What do you mean by antacid? Means again,
which is used to
digest. So antacid means, or we can say antacids. Antacids also we can call it as what? Antacids means which are opposite to the acids are called as antacids or antacids. So which are opposite to the acids, we used to call it as what? They are only known as bases, correct? So we have two bases which are used to consume as antacid to control the common antacids used for curing indigestion due to the acidity. So this acidity is causing, when it will cause, because when you are consuming excess of various, like different reasons may be happening. Maybe mucus is not secreted, or maybe some kind of problem in digestive system, or else if you are eating over spices, or else some kind of indigestion, or else overeating. This all are the reasons of acidity only. Cut or not? Various reasons. Major reason is maybe because of this overeating only. So we are using two antacids or antacids to make neutralize our stomach and to get a relief from the acidity. That is what? One is what? Milk of magnesium, mixture of sodium hydroxide and water. So the first antacid which we are going to start, we have to remember MCQs, MgOH twice. So this is also we can say called as what?
Milk of magnesium.
So it is a mixture of MgOH, magnesium hydroxide plus water. That is what we should say, milk of magnesium. We understand? And the second one for our class 10th, we have only two antacids. That is sodium hydroxide. Is a strong base. Do you understand, Ra? We cannot use that. Sodium hydrogen
carbonate.
carbonate. So what is the another name of sodium hydrogen carbonate? Anybody? Please make a point.
Bicarbonate.
This fastly.
Sodium bicarbonate.
Baking bicarbonate.
That is also all of you should know.
Baking soda.
Sodium bicarbonate. The common name, this is what the scientific names. What is the common name? Common name is to call as
baking soda.
So, we should remember this. This is what we should call as what? The two antacids which we have in our cluster. Are you understand? Arun Gardegayan? Everybody? Yeah. So if you'll go with the next one, there's so many options are there. Make a call for them fastly. Padmavarshini, good morning. Are you understand, Varshini? So now let us come to here.
Morning, sir. Yes,
the next one, the second importance of pH in everyday life, that is also the major number of people are facing this problem. That is what? Tooth decay. Understand? The second problem. See, each and every point, just knowing the heading is doesn't matter. Now, for MCQs, yesterday even we have been attended one webinar. You may know, you may heard, understand? NEP 2020. Very, very difficult, very, very tricky they are going to be asking. For example, I will ask in our biology only one question. Suppose I will give you carbohydrates, fats and oils, a single option, proteins and water. Which is a more source of energy? Can anybody say? That is also they have given in the form of a flow chart. Flow chart they have been given. So which is a more energy source of energy and can you able to say? I have taken everything 100 grams, 100 grams, 100 grams. So which will provide you more amount of energy? Anybody?
Carbohydrates, sir.
What?
Carbohydrates, sir.
Very good. Who said carbohydrates?
Carbohydrates.
Very good. Anybody?
Sir.
Because, why? What is the reason behind? What is the reason behind? Because it is the fastest digestible food. Is it yes or no? Easily can digest and release instant energy. Yes or no? That is why you can see glucose we are consuming while you are running or while you are playing sports or any other thing. Because instant energy, easily digestible. So that it will produce a lot of amount of energy compared to the proteins, fats and oil. So what is the major food? We are getting the energy from our body, required amount of energy from our body, majorly from carbohydrates only. Is it yes or no?
Yes,
that is. So that is also they have given in the form of pie charts, like a percentages you can observe in the mathematics and all. For example, I'm saying pie charts. This is the water percentage. This is the carbohydrates, oils and fats, protein, like that they have been given. So very difficult to find it. Do you understand? Logical based thinking. Everything should be like, you cannot decide at a single shot. Reason assertion also. Very, very tricky. Like there is a something behind. Something is fishy. You have to find the proper connection between them. Unless until you are unable to get the correct answer. What you are guessing, maybe so many times it is going to be wrong. Already have experience, biology exam, correct? Most of you have done wrong in reason assertion. Have you seen it? Yes or no? That is. So, please very, very careful while we are studying it. Good morning, Jesse. Please make a call to Pranita. So many are not there. Please inform them. Just maybe they are tired or maybe they are not wake up. Just give a message call, they will wake up. So, second one. Then are you there in meeting? So, what is the second one? Let us come to here. The pH, importance of pH in our everyday life. The second importance is pH change at the cause of tooth decay. pH change as the what? Cause of tooth decay. So in biology, I have taught you already. What do you mean by tooth decay? The spoiling of our teeth. Is this or no? So it has been eaten up by acids which has been secreted in our mouth. Is it yes or no? Please tell me. Anybody?
Sure.
Yes, biology I have been taught or not? Three layers of teeth, everything I have taught you. Have you remembered? Yes, now let us come to here. The pH change as the cause of tooth decay. How, sir? What is the phenomena behind how this tooth decay is causing? So you may heard we have a myth that tooth decay is causing by because of some kind of a beetles. And some videos also you may watch in YouTube. Something is like a small beetles are coming out from the teeth. Have you noticed it? Tooth decay? But that is all actually trash. Already I have taught in biology. It is all completely trash. That people like just making something like interesting or making us fools, they will say it has been causing by some kind of beetles inside the black one. They will try to bring some kind of something. That is all actually mass that people used to make us fools. But nothing is happening. There is not causing by anything like a living organism. Causing by only because of water. Because of the pH change in our mouth. Because of our mistakes we people are doing. So it is causing. That is only. So what is the reason behind, we'll see now. So when we eat food containing sugars, that is why you can see childhood, those who will eat more amount of chocolates, consuming chocolates more and more and more, definitely so many of them, they will face the tooth decay problem. Have you noticed it? Please tell me. Yes, Pranav. So tooth and consuming more number of chocolates, they will get majorly this tooth decay problem. Even I also faced at a certain situation, only one teeth. Later, it never came to me. Actually, before, I think, means when the first time second time repeating the teeth, again, regrowth. Before that, it has happened to me. I remembered still. So many days, I used to felt so much of pain. But one day, it has been removed from the cavity. So later, nothing has been repeated. So that is like, I think by the time I may be some problem. So that depends upon the food where we are consuming. It is maybe pH value of our mouth will change. It is only causing for tooth decay. So when we eat food containing sugars majorly, when we are eating, what kind of food drop? The food which is contains
sugar.
Of like the sweet, like glucose, sucrose, etc., etc. Then the bacteria present in our mouth break down the sugar to form acids. All of you should remember. So our mouth is a source of, we are the host for lots of bacteria. Do you understand? Our stomach, our mouth, our ears, each and every part of our body having a host for some other kind of bacteria. So many living organisms will be there. So when we eat the food which contains sugar, so the bacteria in our mouth, whatever the bacteria present in our mouth, understanding, which will start break down. What it will do, it will break down the sugars and it will start producing what? It will start producing the sugar into sugar to form water. To form acids. That is what you have to remember. So it will start reacting with these sugars and will start forming the acids. So for example, what kind of acids are? That acids also I'm giving you. Like for example, such as lactic acid. What will happen? Like example, I'm saying lactic acid, very, very important because it may be also come as MCQ. Understand? So everybody will say some acid. What is that acid? Like lactic acid. So this acid, understand, acid is formed in the mouth after a sugary food has been eaten. So whenever you are eating a sugary containing foods like a sweets or some kind of something, whatever it is, sweet in taste, containing sugars. So this all, once you will eat, after that, the sugar, this sugary food, they will start forming the acid. So this acid lowers the pH in the mouth. That is what you have to remember. So pH value is decreases, it will become, if it is turns into acids, the pH value decreases or increases? Let me see who will say. pH value increases or decreases?
Decreases.
You have to tell. pH value will be decreases, correct or not? Acidity is increasing. Acidity is increasing means pH value decreases or increases, Rob? Please tell me.
That decreases.
Remember, so because of to form the acids, understand all of you, remember that. So it will lowers the pH. Very, very important MCQs, understand it, which will lowers the pH in the mouth. So if the pH value is lower, so it will become acidic nature or basic in nature?
Acidic
in nature. Basic in nature, everybody must be clear. So lowers the pH acidic in the mouth. So, making it acidic. What is that? Making it acidic in nature. So, our mouth, what is the state of our mouth now? Yelamati? Nitinath? Where are you, Nitinath? Pranita? So, what is the state of our mouth now? Arvind?
Acidic, sir.
Yeah, Nitinath is not
acidic.
What happened to him? Yeah, so if you
observe, sir, it's not underlying the form.
Okay. So once the lower the pH of the mouth because of we are eating the sweets containing sugary food, so making it acidic in nature. Now here pH value is important. Sir, how much? You are saying that the pH value is reducing. So what is the basic pH value of our mouth? If it is become acidic, what will reduce us? Again, what we have to do? That is what we have to know, that remedies. Now, if you observe very carefully, all of you, so the tooth decay starts when the pH of acid forms in the mouth falls below 5.5. All of you should remember. So when we are going to get the tooth decay? When we are going to tooth decay, so tooth decay will start forming when the pH value falls below 5.5. Very, very important MCQ. Please note it down. So once our mouth pH value is falls less than 5.5, all of you should remember. So tooth decay starts when the pH value is less than this. Note it down. Tooth decay starts when the pH value falls below 5.5 pH value. So why means, sir? Then if you'll observe here, because then the acid becomes strong enough to attack the enamel of our teeth. So what do you mean by enamel? Sir, you may think that, sir, why can't it 6 pH? Actually 6 pH, 7 pH value, 7 pH value is neutral. More than 7, what we should call, Rob? More than 7, what we should call? More than 7, we should call as base. Is it yes or no? Basic in nature. So, but if you observe very carefully here, sir, why can't it will may start forming the tooth decay like a 6.5 like that? So once the pH value reaches to 5.5, then the acid is become enough strength to destroy the enamel of the teeth. What do you mean by enamel? I want to know it. Biology have taught you. What do you mean by enamel? That tooth is having
outer covering of teeth.
Outer covering, it is having a speciality. I will ask you, like, which is the hardest part of our teeth? Bottom, I will give you all.
Enamel.
All of you should remember, enamel is the hardest part of our teeth. So once the pH value is falls below 5.5, will become enough. Understand, all of you? The acid will become enough strong to destroy the enamel, understand, attack the enamel of our teeth, and it will start corroding it. What will happen, Ra? It will start corrode. What do you mean by corrode? Anybody? Corrode it. What spoiling. That's all. Understand, all of you? That is, you have to remember. So this is only will cause us. So once the enamel is attacked by the acid, which is having the pH value is less than 5.5. So then that is what we should call as what? It is only sets in. What will sets in, Ra? Tooth decay. What will happen? Tooth decay. Do you understand, all of you? So now here, major important, I am saying you, very, very important, because it is related to the chemistry as well as biology. I am saying it is, the tooth decay is causing for which part of the teeth, Ra? Which part?
Enamel.
Everybody should remember. So this enamel is the hardest material in our body. Is it yes or no? Not only in our teeth, in our upper layer of teeth. So if you'll take in our heart, in our full body, which part is the hardest one, Ra? Hardest material in our body? Enamel. Please, Allah. Enamel. MCQ only. So hardest, it may become under biology, all may become under chemistry also. Everything you should know it. So hardest material in our body. So you may understand it. If you want to melt, if you want to corrode our hardest material of our body itself, the pH value is less than 5.5. So if it is pH is 0, 1, I told you, very highly concentrated acid, within a second, the full body is going to be disappear. Is it yes or no? Have you remembered? Yes, because it has been corroded, it has been eaten up by the this acidic nature of the acid. So that is why it is very dangerous to handle with the acids, which is the pH value is less than, understanding, 2, like 1.5, 1, 0.5 or 0, etc. Very, very dangerous. So once the pH value reaches to the 5.5, the hottest metal in our body is started corroding. That is what we are calling as tooth decay. Now, my question is, this enamel is made up of what material? That is what I want. It is made up of one chemical compound. Anybody? Karthikeyan, Dilipan, Janani, anybody can say. Prahasini, please, let me come to know. Enamel is made up of what? Anybody, please. Jesse, Pranati, very, very important. You don't know? You guys don't know? Really? So observe very carefully. This enamel is made up of calcium phosphate. What you should call?
Calcium
phosphate. All of you should note it down. Calcium phosphate. Can anybody say what is the chemical formula of calcium phosphate, please? Chemical formula of calcium phosphate. Calcium, what is the formula of calcium?
Ca3PO4 twice.
Huh? Ca3PO4 twice. That is you have to remember. So as we know, calcium, what is the formula? Calcium, how much valency plus 2? Is it yes or no?
Sir, calcium.
Phosphate minus 3. Understand? So if we'll make it exchange, that is what a real chemistry student, everything should know the formula. So Ca3PH4 phosphate 2. So this is what the chemical formula of enamel, calcium phosphate. Please all of you note it down, because they may ask you, what is the valency of calcium, what is the valency of phosphate? So you cannot answer, you cannot say that, sir, we have not studied the valencies in class 10 or class 9 that have been studied, because you have to know it. Understand, Pranita, Akhil, Arfan? So this is what the enamel is made up of. So you can see, it started getting corroded when the pH of the mouth is lower than how much, Ra? Even though it is very hottest material in our body, once the pH value is lower, how much, Arvind? Less than?
5.5.
That is how to remember it. So, the best way to prevent this tooth decay is to clean the mouth thoroughly, or else the completely, thoroughly after eating the food. That is the only way. So most of us, we don't have a habit of this. So now, they will ask you the MCQ again here. What is the best method of controlling the tooth decay? So what is the best method? Anybody? What is the best method, Ra? Brushing with the Colgate paste, brushing with the Colgate Max Fresher, etc., etc. They will give options. Or else, by cleaning the mouth thoroughly after eating food. So what is the correct answer?
Cleaning the mouth thoroughly after eating
the mouth. All of you should remember, that is what you can say. Even if you are eating any chocolate or anything, something, immediately you have to rinsing. What do you mean by rinsing, Ra? Like, you can see, we'll keep the water in our mouth and we can see. Like that sound we can make it. Have you noticed it? Please tell me. Yes or no? While you are brushing, you people will do make that sound.
Yes, sir.
Like that sound, you can make it. Correct or not? Just now you may heard. Like what sound I make it. So the same sound you people are going to hear. So that is called as rinsing. What you should call? Rinsing with a lot of clean water. All of you should remember. So whenever you will rinse the mouth after eating any kind of sugary containing foods, so that all the substance which is stuck in our mouth and the teeth, which has been washed away, so that it can be prevent the tooth decay. So the best way to prevent the tooth decay is to what? To clean the mouth thoroughly after eating the food. Please all of you remember. So best method to prevent tooth decay. What is the best method? What is the
mouth after eating.
Yeah, clean the mouth.
Like toothpaste.
Toothpaste illa. Toothpaste every time you cannot. Kevin, understand, Kevin? Thoroughly after eating. Just after eating. Before eating, we will do brush. Is it yes or no, Kevin? Morning. Yes or no?
Sir.
After after eating, just you pour some amount of water in our mouth, clean water. Just start rinsing like that sound we can make it correct or not, like shaking our mouth. Like that is after eating food. That is what you have to remember. That is what we can say. Rinsing. Understand, Ra? Rinsing. Understand? Rinsing it. Rinsing means like a soaking period. Understand? We have to keep some water in the mouth so that all the material which is stuck in the teeth should be come out with that water. And we have to throw that water outside. That is what like a sinking. A sink, near sink we people will do. Have you remembered? That is what. Do you understand, Ra? Rinse it with the clean water. That is. So this is the main thing which we need to take care to prevent the tooth decay. I think now also somebody of you may be having this. But you have to do this. We can easily reduce ourselves. We can control this ourselves by using these kind of instructions. Next, you can see many toothpaste. If you will observe all our toothpaste. Anybody examples of toothpaste? What you are using? Just now I said somebody using Colgate salt, Colgate. Somebody is using Colgate Max Fresh. Somebody is using some other thing. Somebody will use Close Up. So many are there. Is it yes or no? Different kind of brands we people are using. So what is the difference between them? Somebody will say Colgate Max Fresh is best. Somebody will say Colgate toothpaste is best. Even Colgate sensitive teeth, they will say triple cool stripper. So many names they used to come. Correct? Now recently you may observe Colgate coal. Like olden days people are used to brush with Boggu. Tamil what we can say coal. Tamil what we should call? Now also if you go to villages, most of the grandparents, they used to crush that coal and they used to brush it. Have you noticed it? Yes? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
No, if you know. Actually, till now, my grandmother, my mother's mother, she don't know what is paste, etc., etc. She used to crush this coal with the salt and they will make some kind of a powder, mixture. With that only she used to brush every day. And my father's mother, now not, she's dead. See, when she is alive, I used to observe her, she will directly crush the coal in mouth itself and she used to do the brushing. Actually, now the Colgate, you can see, Colgate coal and Close-Up coal paste also. The paste is coming with the coal only. Now again, we are sifting to the old methodology, like how we are doing. Yeah, very good, Dina. Neem stick also. Neem stick is also one of the major brush in our Indian villages. Understand? So they are even, because of them, our teeth even more stronger, their life is also very high. Now because of this brush, we are brushing with a plastic one, so they are reducing the thickness of our cavities, our means the what
I just want to say,
and they are causing us to lose the teeth at early ages itself. It is maybe fashion and all, but we have a lot of disadvantages with the brushing with the teeth, and particularly somebody used to brush with a kar like brushing for them, that all the sensitive materials where that you can see that is all will going to be reduced very fastly. The thickness is going to be affected much faster, so that the tooth will come outside at the early ages like 40 itself. Before even 70 years, grandmothers also having a good teeth, very strong teeth. But we people after 30-40 years itself, we are facing this problem because of that. But we can say modern civilization, etc., etc. But again, we are sitting back into the old things only. Do you understand, Ra? Everything is coming with the now. A paste is prepared with the coal. Paste is prepared with the salt. Understand? Everything is coming back again with the neem. Everything. Because they are only the Ayurvedic or else natural materials which can prevent this tooth decay. So, forget about it. Now, we are not supposed to use the coal or the teeth and this all. Because we have to go with that. Now, coming to here, the best way to prevent is to just rinse the mouth with a lot of clean water. Now, if you take the many toothpaste, they contains bases only. So, what the toothpaste contains, Ra? What toothpaste contains? Majorly, the toothpaste contains bases. Understand? So, why they contains bases? Can anybody say? Why they contains bases? Because our mouth will produce
neutralize the mouth acid.
What is happening? They will neutralize what acid, Ra?
Sir, alkaline.
they will neutralize mouth acid. So the acid which is secreted by mouth. So that is why you remember the pH of toothpaste being about 8. What is the pH value of toothpaste? What is that? 8. Understand? So maximum pH value is varies from 8 to 9. So that is 9 is also not good for us. All of you should remember, because basic nature will again increases more. That is also dangerous for us. So 8 is the pH value, is about the basic, the toothpaste pH value is about how much? 8. All of you should remember. This is also one of the MCQ question. Understand? So using this toothpaste, which are basic for cleaning the teeth, can neutralize the excess acid in mouth and prevent water, prevent tooth decay. That is what you have to remember. Now, if you observe a person, for example, you can consider, let me consider the any one of us. Now, let me consider Pranav. So, if you consider Pranav, understand, suppose, let me think, he is facing a less chances of suffering from tooth decay by changing his eating habits. Suppose you can see, he's already facing with the tooth decay. Now, Pranav don't want to face a problem called as, understanding, tooth decay, because it is very painful and we need a proper treatment also. So, just now he is even not brushing, olden days no paste and all, but still they used to survive because their life habits, understand, the eating habits such as eating less of sugary food like sweets, toffees, ice creams, chocolates and candies, etc, etc. Just you can changing the habit, the eating habits, understand, so how we can control the tooth decay? By changing our eating habits, particularly girls. Girls, whenever they will see ice cream and chocolate, immediately they cannot control their emotions. Immediately they will go and they will attack. Is it yes or no? Girls, even winter season also, you people used to eat the chocolates. I know that. And you people used to eat the ice creams. Is it yes? Please respond me. Boys also, I don't say boys also, but some boys only. Most of the boys don't like even chocolates. Is it anybody who don't like chocolate? So, by changing our eating habits, all of you should remember, by changing our eating habits, we can prevent this. We can prevent this tooth decay. Sir, doesn't mean that, sir, I cannot eat anytime sweets. You can eat, but in a restricted manner. Continuously eating causes even over fat, etc., etc., easily. See, we have a lot of advantages of chocolate. Suppose those who are getting sleepy in nature, if you eat the chocolate, your brain will activate and your brain will work more nicely. That is what you have to be like. Understand, all of you? So even eating ice cream also, recently only I have been studied, if you are eating the ice cream, it will increase the positive nature of our brain. Like negative thoughts will be avoided if you are eating ice cream. But we have a disadvantage of consuming eating of ice creams more. That is causes for what? Formation of acids in our mouth, which will cause us tooth decay. Is it yes or no? So, by changing eating habits, I'm not saying completely stop, but we have to be in a restricted manner. So, by changing eating habits, and we are not supposed to take, we are eating less of sugary foods. Do you understand, Ingra? Not consuming more sugary foods, sugary containing foods. What is that? Like sweets, toffees, like puffs, puff cakes, etc., etc. Next, ice creams, chocolates, candies, Candy Crush, chocolates and candy, etc. So we are not supposed to take this. Then we won't face the any tooth decay. Now I will show you the picture of the tooth decay, how it will be present and how it is eating. You can see. So the tooth decay is attacking which one, Ra? Is it internal part of that or only external part of the teeth? What is the
external part and later it goes inside?
Yeah, that is. It is going to affect on the first only, it will affect on where? It will affect on the stronger part of the teeth, which we used to call as what?
Enamel.
This is what you have to remember it, all of you. So, for example, if you observe this tooth here, have you noticed it? This is only called as what we should call, Ra? What you should call that one? So, this part, if you observe, this is only eaten up by, it is corroded by the acid. That is what we should call as what? tooth decay. You understand that? And you may notice it, most of our toothpaste will give the protection to our mouth. More than how many hours? Just they will give maximum 12 hours protection. Have you noticed it? That is why a good habit of for us, it may be difficult for us. I know that even I also won't follow it. But if those who can do the brushing 2 times per day before sleeping and after wake up, like each 12 hours one time, because our toothpaste and all can protect our mouth by understanding just only maximum 12 hours, more than that they cannot. So that is why, like our school age and all, people will say 2 times better, it is safe to brush the 2 times per day. So this part is only called as tooth decay slowly. So you can see, for this we have a treatment. So if you go to the hospital, so what they will do, they will clean this inside, because food, once the tooth decay will come, food easily can go and will trap inside these holes. Is it yes or no? Have you noticed it? Food can easily trap inside these holes. Yes or no? So it will cause us continuously more corrosion of this enamel. So that is why immediately we have to go consult the doctor. So what they will do means they will clean this tooth, understanding this tooth decay, and they will fill with some kind of amalgam. Have you remembered? Amalgam. Yes or no? Amalgam, some kind of amalgam, which is a mixture of mercury. Do you understand, Ra? Which is a mixture of mercury, but it will be like a paste. Understand? So that is why it is not poisonous. Do you understand, all of you? So somebody, you may see that. So in that inside, they will keep the amalgam, which is a mixture of some kind of chemical. So that they will be pasted inside that hole. So that hole has been covered completely. So again, the tooth decay won't be continued from there. That is what is the treatment for this. Any doubt, anybody, you can ask me. So this is all about the pH value, the second importance of pH in our day-to-day life. Any doubt, anybody? Please let me know.
No, sir.
Now, coming to the third important, this is the most important one, Rob, because most probably the MCQs will come from this only. That is what? Our agricultural land. So please, all of you, keep waiting. Third one. So the third importance. What is the third importance? Can anybody guess by this time now? Class 8 also I have taught, I remembered. Class 8, not class 7th, I think, for you not, another batch of juniors. So, plants and animals are sensitive to pH changes. That is what? Because the agriculture crops will grow not in acidic medium, not in basic medium, neither too acidic or not basic, they won't grow well. So that is the reason always the land should be neutralized to grow the plants very well. Understand? So if not, they cannot grow well. So now that is the third one. So please all of you write. That is plants and animals are sensitive to water, sensitive to pH change. That is what we people will do now. So let's discuss now. All of you, are you ready? See, everything should be noted down. Everything is MCQ. So why I'm teaching this much? Because you people need to understand very well. So shall we go ahead now? So if you'll observe here, everything in our environment, not only plants, not only animals, everything in our environment, it is very sensitive to pH changes. So if it will become too acidic, cannot sustain, too basic also cannot sustain. So the growth of plants and survival of animals, all of you should remember. What is that, Ra? Growth
and survival
ours, if you come here, humans, and including all the animals, what is that? Survival. Do you understand, Ra? So survival of animals, everything is internally connected with this pH changes only. So it will depends on a large extent on the availability of proper pH.